Children, in this video we are going to study about comparison of adjectives. Now adjectives also, they have three different forms: positive form, comparative form and superlative form. So positive form we use when we tell about the quality of a person, means a quality of one person. Comparative we use when we compare between two people. And superlative we use when we are comparing a person or a thing in a group, then we use superlative form. Now you can see that there are some in this table: regular adjectives, irregular adjectives and adjectives with more than two syllables. Now regular adjectives are those adjectives which are ending with, which have the comparative and superlative form ending with er or est. Example, you can see large, larger, largest, clear, clearer, clearest, pure, purer, purest. So these are all the words, they are ending with er or est. That's why they are known as regular adjectives. There are some irregular adjectives too, which do not end with er or est, but they have some other different forms. For example, good, better, best, bad, worse, worst, far, further, furthest, many, more, most. So these are irregular adjectives. Now adjectives with more than two syllables. Now syllables here means two vowel sound. Those adjectives which have more than two vowel sound. You can see here, in large, there are two vowel sound. Clear also, pure, only one vowel sound. Irregular, two vowel means one vowel sound. Good, then bad, one vowel sound. So but in this intelligent, so there are more than two vowel sounds are there. So these kinds of adjective, confused, similarly, so they do not end with er or est. They end with, they take one more word along with that. In comparative degree we add more with them, and in superlative degree we use most. So intelligent, more intelligent, most intelligent. Confused, more confused and most confused. So now these are some rules are given here, which you have to go through, you have to keep in mind, because these are very important. Now where do we use comparative degree? We use comparative degree whenever we make an unequal comparison. Unequal comparison means, for example, this room is larger than the earlier one. The air in the hills is purer than in the city. So these comparative forms, they take then. They are followed always by then. You can see in the first sentence, larger than, purer than. So unequal comparison, when we make an unequal comparison, we use comparative degree. Negative comparison, whenever we use negative sentence, at that time we can use the positive degree of adjective. Negative comparisons, whenever we use the negative comparison, we often use positive degree. For example, my left arm is not as strong as my right arm. We are doing not is there, negative comparison is there. He is not as hard working as his sister. Then the third rule is, when making a comparison at the same level, we use positive degree of adjective. The film is as interesting as its prequel. Means both the part, both iska pre part was also interesting and the film whole is also interesting. Some say Kolkata is as fascinating as Cairo. So equal comparison is there here. Positive degree is used when the comparison is at the same level. Next rule, when one thing or person is singled out in group, we use the superlative degree of adjectives. Whenever we compare a person or a thing in a group, then we use superlative degree. My brother is the tallest boy in this group. The next part, that is the this is the exercise which is given F that you have to do, and order of adjective. Next topic, that is order of adjective. Now how to use the adjective? Sometimes nouns takes before write one adjective also, we can write more than one adjective also. So what should be the order, which order should be followed, whether we should write qualitative adjective before, quantitative before, means what should be the order. So here in this table they have shown how we should follow this order. Certain order should be followed. So for example, you can say opinion. If opinion is there, we'll write opinion about that thing. Then we write size, then we write other qualities, then we write age, then color, then origin, then material, then type, then purpose, at last purpose. So this is the order that should be followed for writing the adjective. Examples they have given, opinion mein we can write the words like perfect, nice, horrible, ordinary. In size we can write large, vast, big. Other qualities we can write fast, important, angry. Age, old, ancient, new, recent. Color, white, black, green, blue. Origin, Indian, Japanese, Malaysian. Material, steel, iron, stone, plastic, paper. Type, an electronic gadget. A political statement, a train journey. A sports car, bath towel, face wash, restrooms, picture frame, all these are for the purpose. Now you can see here the one more rule is given here. Now they are saying, they have given the example here, they have an impressive, extensive new metro rail transport system. So rail transport system is, before that we have used rail transport, we have used so many adjectives here. We have used impressive, what is the opinion, then extensive, that is the size, then the new, then the metro, all these are this way. Then the next example you can see, they travel in those awful, rickety, old road transport. So this is also, this is the way how we should use these adjectives, using commas. Now commas are used between adjectives that precede and modify the noun. For example, you can see, that is a big, heavy, bulky box. So there are three adjectives are used here before the box: big, then heavy, then. So what we can write, we can use the commas after big, then heavy. Bulky we do not use. So commas are not used when the first adjective modifies the second adjective and the second adjective modifies the noun. For example, the smart new teacher. So this is, teacher is modified by new, and new is modified by smart, means they are interconnected. So then we do not use the commas. But when they are not interconnected, then we use the commas. So do these exercises, and then I send you the answers in the next class.